Are you learning Arduino programming? Check out our membership program to learn the software and hardware skills you'll need to build your own projects. You'll get an all-access pass to our high-quality video training that covers everything from the basics of programming, like variables and control structures, up to using interrupts, arrays, and more. Follow the link in the description to sign up today. The kind of serial communication that takes place between two USARTs is sometimes referred to as TTL serial. TTL stands for transistor-transistor logic, which we won't be diving into here. It's this TTL serial communication that we will use as a basis for our discussion of serial communication. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of this TTL serial communication. How does it work? Well, it's pretty cool. Each USART has a transmit and receive pin. The transmit pin of the sending device is connected to the receive pin of the receiving device and vice versa. By modulating the transmit pin state, making it a high to send a 1 or a low to send a 0, the sender is able to transmit a message over a connecting wire. The receiver reads the pin state at its transmit pin to determine what was sent. Serial communication protocol goes something like this. First, you send a start bit, which is going to be low. And it's basically saying, hey, I'm getting ready to send a message. Then you send a set number of bits, which is often 8. And this is your message, which is also known as the data frame. After the data frame, you can send an optional parity bit, which is used for error checking. Finally, you send a stop bit, which is always going to be high. And that's saying, hey, the message is now complete. This is the kind of serial communication that is taking place when using the Arduino serial library. For example, with functions like serial begin and serial print. If you're not familiar with serial begin or serial print, make sure to check out the description to links to other lessons that we have on both of those topics. All right, so let's look at a concrete example.